Hello, John Bloodworth, Gentleman Crafter here. This week I've been playing around with my digitizing software and taken this screen printed canvas that I made a while ago and turned it into this stitched image using the Color PhotoStitch effect in Hatch Embroidery Digitizing software. This feature is only available in the digitizer level of the software, so if you are looking to grab that, you'll need to be aware of that. I've already got my machine set up in the software, but I wanted to use a smaller hoop, so I changed that size. And then also, I right-clicked on the hoop icon and changed my hoop position to manual so that it didn't jump around as I was loading and changing things. Next, I loaded the artwork, and this was basically a photograph that I took of the screen printed canvas, and that was screen printed onto a batik fabric. Next, I resized it by holding down the shift key, left clicking one of the corner handles and dragging that down to fit within the hoop, or I could of course have manually entered the dimensions in the boxes at the top as you see there. Next up, I'm going to open the sequence tab so you can see that the image has been loaded. Then I'm going to go over to the auto digitize palette and click on Color Photo Stitch. This is going to load my image into the photo stitch converter. And generally the default will be 7 colors. You can change that up to a maximum of 15. I'm setting the resolution as high so that I get finer detail from the stitching. Then in the adjust dialog box, which I have to click to open, I'm going to increase the contrast to 50. I found through experimentation that the higher the contrast, the better the results. I'm just going to check through the colors here to see that I've got enough of the colors in my threads to work with. I think there's a few too many pinks, so I reduced the color load down to 10, and that looks about right. I've got a nice variety of colors there to work and choose from. So I click OK, and that then converts the image into the photo stitch fill. Now, one thing I have noticed is that it adds the colors to the palette, so I will discard unused colors by clicking on discard. I also pointed out the number of stitches here because my machine has a maximum of 50,000. Now, something else I've noticed is that the sequence of the colors doesn't always give you the best results, so you can of course use the sequence tab to move those layers around and give you a better result. Something that I also wanted to do before I saved out my design was to load a relevant color palette of thread charts and assign individual threads to each of those colors. There are lots and lots of thread color charts to choose from, so whichever thread manufacturer you choose to use, you will most likely find it in Hatch Embroidery Digitizing software. Now I can search for color by number, so in this case black would be 900. And to assign that to the color, I would make sure the relevant layer is selected in the sequence tab and then click on that color, and as you can see it's now assigned that color, but the others are just still in their red, green, blue numbering format, so I would need to do that for each of the colors. You can also search for colors by name, and hopefully you can then match it up with something that's in your palette. You'll just need to be aware of the numbers you give, purely because on your machine it may only display the color number and not the name. It depends on your machine. Now, in addition to resequencing the colors themselves, You can also resequence the individual elements of the design. Now, I find to do this, it's best to select everything with Control and A, then Control and left click on the color that you want to work with to deselect it, then right click and hide all of the other colors. And now you can just see what's there. I also turn the true view off so that I get the jump stitches as well. That's the key thing that I want to check out here, because the sequencing isn't always the best for avoiding those jump cuts. Yes, it's going to be great for things like your pull compensation, but sometimes it's, in my mind, better to be able to resequence so that it runs in a logical order. Now, you can select the individual parts in the sequence tab, or you can select them over on the main canvas as well. You can even delete sections where they're just going to be a couple of stitches and won't make a difference to the design, and that will then help hopefully tidy things up for you. Generally, I'm just going down in number sequence, as this is the sequence that your machine will stitch out. And if I find anything that's going to be a major problem, I will resequence it using the up and down arrows at the bottom of the sequence tab. Or, as I mentioned, I will delete something and get rid of it and see if that makes a difference. Once I'm happy with one color, I go back and unhide everything and repeat the Control A, Control left click to get the next color. So you can see we've got lots of little bits going on with this green one. So you can see the order these are going to stitch out. And the jump cuts also show you where that stitch is coming from and where it's going to. So you can avoid lots of overlaps. In all honesty, I'm not too fussed about the first maybe 50% of the layers, so the first 5 layers in this case, as they will most likely be covered by the final 5 layers. I do, however, try and avoid any massive jump cuts that are going to go over other colours, mostly by just cutting them as I'm working through stitching all the colours on the machine. So just jumping ahead here all the way to the end colour, which is the black. So that would be at the bottom of the sequence tab. And just checking that this isn't lots of little bits, it's mostly just a massive group. So I've got the first few there. And then this stitch here, I noticed on the finished stitched out design, wasn't too great, as it kind of had no context, so I deleted it. And you can see how everything else has just been reorganized to take that into account. Again, just going through, and then pow, massive at the end. Now, all this stuff over on the right is not really going to make too much of a difference to the final stitched out result. So again, I selected it all and got rid of it. Every stitch saved, in my case, is a bonus. Okay, just going through again to make sure that's still relevant. And I think that's going to be fine. So what I'm going to do is unhide everything, and then I'll do a quick stitch out using the stitch player in the Hatch Embroidery Digitizing software with my true view activated, and that will give me a good idea of whether I've got the colors in the right sequence, and of course whether I need to make any other changes. So I have got this massively sped up. I've actually increased it, I don't know, by about 50 times. So you can tell that this is going to take a while to stitch out. So do make sure it's a, you know, it's not a quick 5 minute stitch. Even on 2000 stitches a minute, this took around 30 minutes to actually run through the player. And my machine works at about 350 stitches a minute. So you can tell it's going to be a long stitch, but it's worth it in the end because kapow, there is the finished result. I love this photo stitch effect, and I'm going to look at using it with my abstract art. How fun. That's it for this time. If you've enjoyed this video, please remember to give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments section below. And for more from me in the future, please remember to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching.